Hi everybody, good morning. It's Mrs. Pompang. And today I thought we'd do a sketch of, well, you know what? Let's start out by doing some shapes and let's see if you can guess what it could be. Put a line down like that. Let me get a little bit darker so you can see. I'm gonna put another line over here. And I'm gonna put a line going this way. This way. And one over here. It looks like I'm drawing a box. Over here, what I'm gonna do is put a straight line. A vertical line coming down from that. Basically, I'm just building some shapes. Very simple. Over here, it's gonna create another rectangle looking thing. Over here, another one. It's a lot of less little squares, it looks like, right? Let's see. I need to put some rectangles in this. So let's put one right here. Now if you gotta draw up your lines, don't worry about it. That's what sketching is about. I'm not even using an eraser. There's no eraser on the back of this pencil. We're just doing some shapes. I'll let you catch up there for a second. Okay, over here, I'm gonna have another rectangle. Another one over here. This one's more of a square. Another rectangle over here. When you build a drawing, like I said, a sketch is built on a lot of lines, a lot of different lines, shapes. Over here, put another rectangle over here. Come up above that line a little bit here. Rectangle there. And I'm gonna make a smaller one over here. Right here, make another rectangle. Another rectangle there. Gonna make another line down here, vertical. All right, now let's see. We're gonna do some triangles, basic triangles. So over here, a little tiny one there. Bit bigger than that one right here. I'll take a larger one over here. One similar to this size, maybe a little bit bigger than this one over here. Another one here. Over here, on top of this rectangle, another triangle. So far we've done rectangles and triangles, keeping it pretty simple. Now, I need to add a couple of small little squares. So I'm gonna show you where I'm gonna add them. Up here, on the top over here. So, squares. Lights will appear, over here. Let's make some squares on this line right here. Whoops. Drawing's trying to take off there. So over here, put some little squares over here. In front of these other squares with the triangle on top. I'm gonna go ahead and put some more squares over here. Actually inspired to do this drawing by my niece Olivia. We're going to call her Princess Olivia today. So I was inspired to do a castle because I know that she really likes princesses and unicorns. Those are her favorite things. So Olivia, this is your shout out from Mrs. Pompang's online drawing tutorial. Over here, let's create a long rectangle that goes this way. And line going down. I'm going to do a slanted line going this way. Because what I'm going to do over here is turn this into a moat where there's water coming through here. Now over here, let's put a horseshoe shape. It's always awesome to keep a sharpener on hand. Sharpening away. Hey, let's put some color value and shading into our drawing along with some accents of some stone and rock. I'm just going to create the look of a landscape coming up around here. Color value into these areas here. I'm just using a basic pencil. And when I use pencil, I like to use value in my drawings. Drawings with value are drawings with shading, different shades of color. It could be the same color. So you go from like a dark shade to a medium shade to a lighter shade to an even lighter shade. Oops, sorry about the shaking. There we go. Secret song to you each night we are apart. now what I'm going to do is put some more little rectangles here and there scattered throughout. Now, you can put as many or as little as you would like. You can really make your castle any way that you want it. I'm going to go ahead and shade in some of my little triangular shapes here, leaving half of them light and half dark. I'm going to do some shading over here, dark shading. This is like water coming through a little bridge here. I'm just kind of shaded in. It's not important over here, but I just wanted to kind of have a little area of dark and then a little area of white for some contrast in our drawing. I want to create in the background a mountain, maybe a larger mountain. Let's put some stones in our castle because this looks like it has a lot of stones in it. I'm going to use some size differentiation in my drawing, so I'm going to draw some circles the size of Skittle candies, and I'm going to move my camera down, there we go, and down here, let's do some circles down here. I'm just kind of repeating them over and over again. It's okay if they touch or kind of overlap. I'm just putting in some stones here. also did all kinds of circles. Add some more circles in the building, but a little bit smaller. So I'm going to sharpen my pencil again. Once again, it's very good to have a sharpener, you guys. Now just throw some circles in here, little ones. I think we need some stones over here on this side too. So this side here is going to have stones like this side. Just making some circles, overlapping them. Here I have some windows. I want to try to not go around those with the stones, so. So go ahead and put some circles in there, fill it up, and put some shadowing in there just so you can kind of see that. And we need some brickwork here, but this brickwork is going to be a little different. This is going to be kind of... This, we're going to make it look kind of bricks. Some bricks in there. Just making some vertical lines. You saw me go horizontal, now I'm just making some vertical brick lines in there. Just skip around. Darken it up around the edges here. Okay. Now, this part of the castle over here does have a stone wall, so we have to put some more shapes that are kind of stone-like here. Doing some larger circles here. Feels like a Skittle size. Let you catch up. gonna do a slight adjustment. Hopefully I won't lose my footing here. I've done that in a few times in other videos. Okay, some, I'm gonna get some bricks over here. And then the horizontal line's going across again. And then I'm gonna just put some randomly scattered going down. Here I'm just gonna kinda darken up my windows a little. Gonna do a little bit of shading over here. Just light color value. Some stones up here in this castle part up here. Got those beautiful windows up there, so just kind of darken them up so we don't lose them in the stones. You can see them? They're up here. And some over here too. I'm just gonna darken off a little bit. Getting a sharpening break for a minute. Here, I'm going to create a little house structure. This roof is dark. How are you doing so far? I'm gonna put some stones over here. So little tiny stones again, you guys. Repetitive circles. Don't lose your windows in the circles there. They're the little tiny little rectangles I put in there. We wanna kind of keep those, don't lose them. Get up in those little squares too, put those little circles in the little squares. I'm gonna go ahead and get over here, more circles. I can see some places that are missing some shading.
Forget about your worries and your strife.
Now I think we need some more horizontal lines going here in this rectangle. And then some vertical lines scattered around going down. It's gonna give it the illusion of some little bricks. Yeah, let's darken up these windows a little bit. And we're gonna put some circles in here. Really tiny ones. Gives the illusion of some stones in the castle. Stones in a castle. Really old castles of like places like Ireland and England have a lot of round stones in them. Spot I see here that could actually use some stones. More small circles. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a simple tool that everybody has, and that is called your finger! Woohoo! One finger. And I'm going to do some blending with my finger. So I'm going to just start, let's see, I'm going to do the little triangular roves. Let's start by blending those. Making ravioli for your friends. Blending, blending, blending. Blending, blending. So you can serve dinner without ad breaks. Blending, blending. Try YouTube Premium with 1 month free and cook uninterrupted. Blending, blending, blending. Down here, some blending. Finger turns really, really, really black. It's okay, it's great for blending. So I'm just gonna blend in some spots. Blending, blending, blending. Do some shading, maybe just kind of randomly here and there and here. Turn it to slight adjustment again. Oops, up the top. Maybe doing some slight blending in the background where the mountains are. So I have pretty much just gone ahead and shaded. Here you can see. And if you haven't figured out what it is yet, it is a castle, a princess castle. So I just gone ahead and done this in pencil. So Olivia, I'm hoping that you really dig this princess castle because it was made in mind for you. So, and my students, I hope if you'll give this drawing a try. It's pretty easy. Triangles, rectangles, you know, couple other shapes here and there, maybe a square here and there, and then some kind of organic lines here and there, but mostly it is rectangles and squares. So I think that you guys should give it a try. I'm really excited to see, you know, your drawings. If you want to send them, please feel free to send them to my school email. It's in the Google Classroom link, and I'll be happy to take a look at what you did and comment, you know, and you're welcome to comment on the videos. Tell me if you like them. Tell me if you'd like to see other things. What other things would you guys like to draw? What other kind of tutorials would you like to see? And last but not least, you should always sign your artwork. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today, drawing a castle using some basic shapes with Mrs. Pompang. Thank you for watching Mrs. Pompang's online art drawing tutorial. And let's sign our name. And put the year on there. And I hope you enjoyed this. And like I said, please send me pictures of your work. Keep watching. There'll be other tutorials to come of interesting things. And I look forward to having you follow and seeing your artwork and the result. Take care, everybody. Have a great day today.